So here I have an example, which is a bipartite graph, and this is my graph G. Okay, so step one is to make a graph G prime out of this. And the way I make G prime of this, first of all, is to make all my x's, my edges, directional, like so. And then to create a new node S and put edges from S to every node in my x set. Create a new node T, put edges from every node in my y set to T. And then place a capacity of 1 on every single edge that appears here, which will get tedious if I do it, but I guess I can start anyway. Okay, so 1 on every single edge. Okay, I'm bored already. So let's move on and proceed to do the Ford-Fulkerson algorithm on this. So our first step in Ford-Fulkerson is to draw the residual graph. So my residual graph right there is, well, actually my residual graph is exactly the same as this graph right here, because the only thing I can do is push things forward, right? So let me, I guess I better go ahead and label the capacities on everything, like so. Okay, so from this residual graph right here, which is exactly the same as our original graph, I need to find a path from S to T that follows along my direction. So how about S goes to X goes to T? Okay, now the bottleneck for that path, the bottleneck for all paths that we're dealing with, because every single edge has the value T, is obviously 1, the minimum of 1 and 1 and 1. So the bottleneck is 1. So what that means then is I go to my original graph, and I'm going to redraw it right here. Okay, and every edge in this augmenting path that I have, I will add 1 to the current flow on that edge. So from S, oh dear, S to A, I need some room, S to A to X, there we go, yeah, S to A to X to T. So from S to A, I will have a flow of 1 out of my capacity of 1. From A to X, that's what I have right here, I will have a flow of 1, capacity of 1, and X to T, flow of 1, capacity of 1, and everything else stays exactly the same. Okay, flow of 0 out of 1, 0 out of 1, 0 out of 1, etc. Okay, next step is to draw my residual graph for this graph right here. Alright, so let me just draw my nodes first, because it helps me to have something to anchor onto. Okay, from S to A, there's nothing more I can push forward, but I could undo 1 unit of flow. From A to X, ditto. Undo 1 unit of flow. X to T, ditto. Okay, S to B, I can go forward with 1 unit. B to X, I can go forward with 1 unit. B to Y, forward. Y to T, forward. S to C, forward 1 unit. C to X, forward 1 unit. C to Y, forward 1 unit. And C to Z, forward 1 unit. And Z to T, forward 1 unit. Okay, we need an augmenting path here. How about I choose, let's see, I can't choose SA, but I could choose SB. I can't choose X next, because I don't get to T that way, but I could choose SBY and T. So SBY, T, SBY and T, and the bottleneck for that is 1. So now I want to take these edges right here that I chose from my augmenting path, go back to my original graph right here, and just update my flows with my new bottleneck on the corresponding edges. So S to B, I'll have a flow of 1 out of capacity of 1. B to Y, right here, I'll have 0 plus 1 gives me a flow of 1 over a capacity of 1. Y to t, right here, 0 plus 1 gives me a 1 over a capacity of 1. So there is my new graph right there. Okay, so from this graph, so now I'm done with this. So let me just sort of X that out, because I'm done with it. I don't want to reuse it. So now let me do a new residual graph, which I believe will be my last one. And to do this, I'm going to draw my nodes again. Okay, this is this graph right here that I'm doing the residual graph of. Okay, so S to A, I can undo 1. A to X, undo 1. X to T, I can undo 1. S to B, right here, I can undo 1. B to X, I could push forward 1. B to Y, I can undo 1. Okay, oops, 1. And then Y to T, I can undo 1. Okay, S to C, I can go forward 1. C to X, I could go forward 1. C to Y, I can go forward 1. C to Z, I can go forward 1. And then Z to T, I can go forward 1. All right, now I need my augmenting path. Let's see. I can take S and then C. Can't choose X because I can't get to T. C to Y. Again, I can't choose Y because I can't get to T. C to Z, I could do that one. And then Z to T. So there's my augmenting path. S, C, Z, T. Okay, the bottleneck is the min of 1 and 1 and 1. So that gives me a bottleneck of 1. Let me go back up here to this graph and update my edges with my new flow. So right here, S to C, I have 0 plus 1 gives me 1. C to Z, 0 plus 1 gives me 1. And Z to T, 0 plus 1 gives me 1. Okay, now when I do the residual graph for this graph right here, which I'm not going to draw because I don't think you need me to, you can see in the residual graph, just looking at S, I could undo the S to A, so I'll have an in edge. This is for the residual graph I'm creating now. I'll have an in edge onto S of capacity 1. I'll have an in edge from B, capacity 1, and an in edge from C, capacity 1. There's no way to find an augmenting path that starts at S and goes anywhere. So I'm all done finding augmented paths, and this is my answer to the maximum flow right here. Okay, now what I need to do is from this maximum flow, find my matching, and that will tell me what my maximum M is. So let's proceed to do that. Okay, here was the result of doing the Ford-Fulkerson algorithm on my G prime. Let's go back to my original G and see what we have here. So my original G has A, B, C, X, Y, Z. And here, wherever you see something that has a flow of 1 on it, you want to draw that edge back in. Okay, so B goes to, and I'm finding the M on G. Okay, B has no edge going to X, flow is 0. It has an edge going to Y right there. Okay, C has no edge going to X because the flow is 0. No edge going to Y, the flow is 0. And then an edge going to Z. Okay, so there is my matching right here. The matching equals the set AX, BY, CZ, and the cardinality of M equals 3. Okay, so I would invite you to go ahead and resolve this problem on the same original bipartite graph, but use a different order of augmenting paths, and you will find that you will end up always with the cardinality of the matching you get will be 3.